was a man from the Mushrikeen by the name of Amr ibn Abdi Wud. Amr ibn Abdi Wud was like the boogeyman of Quraysh. Right? He was such a huge person, and he was someone that was so scary, and he was such a fierce warrior that the people used to scare their children with Amr ibn Abdi Wud. They used to scare people with Amr ibn Abdi Wud. And so he was a fierce horseman, and he came out to the Muslims in the Battle of Khandaq, and he taunted the believers from behind the ditch, and he said, "Who amongst you is going to come out and to fight me so that I can send him to this Jannah that he believes in? You guys believe in paradise? Let me send you to paradise. I'll get you there quicker." And the Muslims were quiet. And Ali radiallahu anhu says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ya Rasulullah, let me go." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Hold on, O Ali." And Amr ibn Abdi Wud continues to call out and continues to call out until the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finally allows Ali radiallahu anhu to go forth. And when Ali walks up to this huge man, you know, this person that is truly a scary individual who has so much armor on him that it would take forever to even get to him. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he walks up to him and the man looks at him, Amr ibn Abdi Wud looks at him and he says, "Ya ibn akhi, oh son of my brother, la urid an aqtulak, I don't want to kill you." And Ali radiallahu anhu says, "No, but you don't understand, I want to kill you." So a battle ensues between the two, and the description of it is that none of the Muslims could see anything. They fought in the trench and all they heard were the sounds of the sword and the sounds of all of the armor, and they saw the dirt kicking up, and people were wondering what happened to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. What was the outcome of this battle? Until they saw afterwards that Ali radiallahu anhu was victorious over Amr ibn Abdi Wud as he shouted Allahu Akbar. And whenever he came back to the Muslims, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he asked Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, "How come you didn't take his armor? He had so much armor, why didn't you take his armor?" He said, "Because whenever I struck him, his awrah became exposed and I was too shy to take from his armor." Subhanallah. So he left him in that situation. This shows you this man's tawakkul, his courage. Ana alladhi samatu ummu Haydar. He says, "I am the one whose mother named him a lion when he was," and subhanAllah, and he truly showed that in many instances. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has praised him on so many different occasions, amongst other virtues. In Medina, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam paired off people with their brothers and made brothers between the Muhajireen and the Ansar, by the time Ali radiallahu anhu got there, everything was already done, all the pairing was done. So Ali was sad, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Ali, "Anta akhi fi dunya wal akhirah." You are my brother, O Ali, in this dunya and in the akhirah. In the Battle of Khaybar, right, whenever this fierce battle was ensuing between the Muslims and Banu Qurayda, and subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent some of the Sahaba already through the Battle of Khaybar, and they were not able to win that battle. They were not able to defeat Banu Qurayda. And then finally, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said one day that tomorrow I'm going to entrust the banner with someone who loves Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who is beloved to Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Sahaba, they started to stick their heads out in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They kept on making themselves known in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, showing themselves in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hoping that it would be them. But then the next day, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam entrusted that banner with Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Ali radiallahu anhu was sick. He had an infection in his eye and he could not see from one of his eyes, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took his saliva and he rubbed it on the eye of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Ali radiallahu anhu was cured, and he fought so bravely in Khaybar that he took a door. He actually held a door in the Battle of Khaybar with one hand while he fought with the other one. After he dropped that door, it took 10 men to be able to just pick that door up off of the ground. So subhanAllah, his tawakkul in Allah allowed him to have strength that was almost unhuman.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one hadith is reported to have said, love for Hazrat Ali is sign of Iman, and hatred for Hazrat Ali is a sign of Nifaq. Love for Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu doesn't mean that you have to hate others.
La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.